Anyway, shaking cats and chicks, you know who it is. Super Mario Nick here. Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, it's actually been a highly requested video. And that is how to be a 50s enthusiast. Now, there's really no way. No true, you know, one true way to becoming a 50s enthusiast. But, I have made a poll asking people on what the hell they wanted me to see. They wanted to see this video. Just got a close request. Yeah. Sorry, definitely. Black Terry. Got him. Boom. So. How to be a 50s enthusiast. So, obviously, I can't fucking do this shit. So obviously the first tried and true thing to becoming a 50s enthusiast, you know, you have to have the style. Now, what I'm wearing here, cats and kittens, this is a very traditional 50s attire. You have the flannel, the undershirt, khakis and loafers, specifically the black variety. Because usually I wear like the short sleeves, plaid button ups, but because that's what cats mainly wore in the 50s. But the issue with that is it's fall now, you know. What the heck's it been fucking fall? It's fucking middle of October. So we'd address as a cat for 50s. You know, if you're more traditional 50s cat, conservative, you know, what most cats wore. Of course, you know, you wear your undershirt. Either a short sleeve, but plaid button up like I usually wear, or like a long sleeve flannel. No, that's definitely all there really is for clothes. You know, you could wear a fucking cardigan vest. Cardigan sweater. Or like I usually wear my fucking Letterman jacket. Yeah, the jackets for 50s. There's the Letterman jacket, of course, because you sometimes may wear, you know, there's a black leather jacket, bomber jackets, that's really it. Oh yeah, denim jackets, you know, pants, of course, khakis slash chinos, slacks, and oh shit, and of course, you know, blue jeans. Now, blue jeans were just starting to become, like, not acceptable in the 50s. Like, in the 40s, fucking. If you were walking out, like, the 40s, but that's not this video. It's not if you're fucking walking down the street in the 40s. And you're wearing fucking blue jeans, you're fucking wearing a Levi and Strauss company. Go get your ass done. It's not fucking acceptable. Now, best jean brands from the 50s, definitely a Levi and Strauss company from San Francisco, and Wrangler. Because I can't afford Levi's 501, so I just get Wrangler. It's always straight cut because you gotta cuff them. Gotta roll them out of the cuff. Because I even cuff my khakis, if you can see that. Now, shoot. Now, underwear. I don't even fucking do this. Boxers, you don't wear fucking white tighties. I'm like, what the fuck are you, a fucking nerd? Alright, that's for fucking plaid boxers. Now, for shoes. I'm not even gonna do socks on, but you can research socks if you want to. Now, for shoes, obviously, the most, you know, 50s shoes are fucking this. Fucking loafers. Okay, these are fucking shoe tomorrow. These are my original loafers. The ones I used to wear, they are fucking too small. My mom was too scared I was gonna, like, mess up my fucking feet, so yeah. Also, saddle shoes. They really. The only shoes that were for men's back in the 50s was, like I said, loafers, saddle shoes, and sneakers that were just starting to become existent in the 50s. So there was the Converse on Chuck Taylor All Stars. But that was more associated with the greaser look. And the greaser look, of course, they don't wear fucking button ups, fucking square. They wore into this, like, the white t shirt, like the black t shirt. Like a black leather jacket, or maybe like a black leatherman jacket, or fucking denim jacket. And of course, like some jeans, always high waisted. No matter if going for like a traditional or greaser look, always high waisted. And more darker looks in that they don't think that thing probably like to see it in the 50s was stolen wash. This is what Fonzie used to wear on Happy Days. But it's always high rise jeans, like it's always rolled at the cuff. Yeah. Them greasers, they wore like I said the Chuck Taylors, so they were all fucking more. Some of them wore loafers, like you'll see in James Dean in Rebel Without a Cause, he wore loafers. And Marlon Brando in The Wildwood, he wore engineer boots. Now for hairstyles for cats, this is obviously not a 50s hairstyle. This is a hella 60s ass hairstyle. Fucking Beatles. We have traditional 50s styles for some like side part, of course, you know, slick back, pompadour or quiff slash fucking elephant's trunk. Or, you know, of course, you have your crew cuts, you have buzz cuts, flat tops. That was mainly what was in style back then. Men didn't really have facial hair because the chicks, they don't take facial hair. Now, speaking of the chicks, now, obviously, I'm not a chick, obviously, but I'm going to make a video more in depth on how to get 50s enthusiast chicks soon. But the fashion, goddamn, where is it? Because the fashion for the chicks, of course, you know, your traditional, you know, dress with, like, the patterns, a longer skirt, of course, but, what was a lot of fashion in the 60s, the girls were, like, a short-sleeved sleeve sweater, or a long-sleeve sweater, and they don't tuck into one of their skirts. Now, the skirts in the 50s, even, like, Marilyn Monroe, Jane Mansfield type, a lot of them were, pencil skirts to accentuate their asses. A lot of them, like, regular teenage girls, I didn't wear pencil skirts, actually. You can wear pencil skirts if you want, but a lot of them were, A-line skirts. I think the most, iconic 50s outfit, 50s thing ever, you know, of course, the chicks, the poodle skirts, you know, like your Grease type outfits. You know, when you think of the 50s chicks, you think of, you know, like, poodle skirts. No. Of course, you know, your traditional, like, Audrey Hepburn type, where, you know, she would wear, like, she would often wear, like, white blouses. Now, not that I'm doing this, bras. They didn't have hook bras back in the 50s. They were buttoned right now. And, a lot of them wore push-up bras, because, you know, you have your famous 50s Marilyn Monroe type of cone bra. Often made of nylon. That's what the panties were made out of. Because most teenage girls in the 50s, they didn't wear fucking like skimpy ass panties like they have now. They wore fucking high waisted, high leg panties. Nylon, of course. And back in the 50s, it wasn't really acceptable for girls to wear pants. Some wore capris. Well, it's even with shirts, even. Like your greaser chicks, you'd often see them. They might just be wearing like a white t-shirt, like their boyfriends. All of the rockabilly chicks of the day, I'll put like a photo up, you know, they'd have like their hair in a bandana. And they, now, if you're in the summer, of course, you chicks, by all means, wear shorts. But most times, it was not acceptable for a girl to wear shorts. But like I said, with the photo that I was, the photo that I just showed you guys, they'd often take like a sleeveless, flannel button up and tie up, at the waist. Now, this fucking talk on my head, I don't have a fucking script for this. So like I said, I know girls, they don't often wear pants back then, but sometimes they did. Like, girls, they would often wear capris, your black capri pants. Some of them wore slacks, but not much. Of course, you know, your socks and your traditional bobby socks. A lot of people don't know this, but chicks also actually wore loafers a lot. You know, of course, they wore them. Some alternatives, of course, were Mary Jane's, ballet flats. And of course, high heels, and of course, you know, your fitness. You know, we're going to the, let's go to the hop, and you're fucking pool skirt and fucking saddle shoes. Nah, the chick's hair for the 50s isn't the most iconic. Hairstyles for chicks of the 50s were, of course, the pixie cut, the Italian cut. Of course, they often had like the ponytail with the bangs combo. You know, I think like, yeah, this is like the standard like long coat, like, the side part like Sandra D used to have. It's pretty popular. The Victory Bob, that was Because your 1920s Louise Brooks style bobs, they were not fashionable at all in the 50s. Those didn't come back till the 60s, actually. I like the 60s, but that's not what this video is about. Because you'd see this on Bandstand a lot back in the day. Most of the chicks had the victory bobs. Some chicks had pin curls, like your Grace Kelly type page boys. No, I see the iconic, the hairstyle that the girls would do where they flip the ends of their hair up and like ribbon updo. That wasn't even like a 60s type hairstyle. And I can cover that if I ever do like a 60s enthusiast video. But so that's for also the makeup for chicks. Very colorful on lipstick. Saying cherry red, but I know Natalie Wood, she liked red. She liked to wear blue. Pink was pretty popular, purple. They didn't really wear lip gloss back then, because I know about the 60s they kind of ditched the lipstick and then more traditional makeup, the lean eyelids with with the lip gloss. But like I said, once again, it's not 60s. Oh wow, it's 50s. Oh wow, this channel is about the 40s, the 50s, and the 60s. So now that you have the fashion, some girls, I forgot to wear jackets for chicks, some girls would wear fur coats. But, also they would wear the cat eye glasses, like Shirley MacLaine used to do. Before the guys, there were some of them, like sunglasses. But anyway, I feel like I'm leaving something out, because I don't fucking know. Also, when it shakes, the dresses can be long sleeve, short sleeve, or even no sleeves. That was kind of a skate for the 50s, but yeah, it's kind of cool. Also, for the cats, I forgot to mention this, of course, suits were pretty popular. Now, you ask the average teenage boy of, I don't know, fucking 1956, do they wear a suit? They probably would say, no, I'm not a dad, I don't wear suits. Let's not go over this, I don't know. The chicks, they would wear the neck scarves, of course. That was pretty popular. Accessory in the 50s. Well, we're gonna move away from the. Also, nobody had fucking tattoos in the 50s. That's fucking nasty. The guys, they didn't have fucking piercings because they weren't fucking gay in the 50s. Also, if you're speaking of cats, if you have bad eyesight, you would wear your big Buddy Holly type glasses. But what I was going with here, girls especially didn't have tattoos. If you had a tattoo in the 50s, you were pretty trashy. The girls, that they only pierced their ears, they were like studs, like Audrey Hepburn. She used to wear like the gold hoop earrings, but oh girl, no, like fashion, okay, wow. I guess now, music, no. You can't be a 50s enthusiast if you don't dress the part, but you also can't be a 50s enthusiast if you don't listen to the right music. So, no, your rock and roll, your rockabilly, of course, Elvis, Chuck Berry, Little Richard, Buddy Holly, Eddie Cochran, Bill Haley and the Comets, Bo Diddley, the Everly Brothers, Ricky Nelson, Dion, Richie Valens, Guy Mitchell, that's all I've got. See, I know I'll get Bobby Darin, Bobby V, Bobby Rydell, Danny and the Juniors, Wanda Jackson, Janis Martin, Johnny Cash. That's right, the Beach Boys for a little bit, the very, very, very late 50s. The Beatles, they were there for a little bit. Connie Francis, of course. Johnny Cymbal. For some reason, this is literally all that's coming to mind. The Silhouettes. The Angels, Leslie Gore, all the greats, And most of those people that I listed were not rock and roll. So, let me try this again. So, start with rock and roll / rockabilly, okay? Elvis, Chuck Berry, Gene Vincent, Bill Haley and his Comets, Danny and the Juniors, Dion. I can't just sit here and list off all of this, okay? So, of course, you have your rock and roll. So, I'm not even going to separate these artists into genres. So, the main genres you'd be listening to the 50s, rock and roll / rockabilly. Your teen pop or your adult pop, jazz, of course, was still in fashion. Big band, mostly out. Of course, you got to know the doo-wop. not an artist of the 50s, with, like, pictures up of them. Yeah, that's not by genre, but one second off the top of my head, Elvis, Little Richard, Buddy Holly, Bill Haley and His Comets, Eddie Cochran, Richie Valens, The Big Bopper, Guy Mitchell, The Everly Brothers, Connie Francis, Little Richard, Chuck Berry, Chubby Checker, Leslie Gore, The Beatles, The Beach Boys, The Angels. How did I forget this man? Ricky Nelson, Pat's Domino. I can't remember. I think I mentioned Buddy Holly. Bobby Darin, Bobby V, Danny and the Juniors, Connie Francis, Wanda Jackson, Hank Williams, Ennis Martin. You know, all greats of the 50s music. So, really the true way to be a 50s enthusiast, you have to look the part and listen to the right music. Now, most likely you want to listen to the music on records, but if you're like me, and well, parents won't get you records, or if you're older and you live by yourself and you just can't afford records, you have to sadly listen to the music on your phone. Oh wow. I have a radio actually. The radio station I listen to most of the time, I play 70s and 80s, but every Saturday night from 8 to 10, they play the best of pre-British Invasion, so that would have been 54 to 64. And then from 10 to 1, they play 10 p.m. to 1 a.m., they play the best of the 60s. So it's pretty good. So I listen to that, the radio shows every night, or Saturday night. That's music. Of course, you gotta watch the old TV shows, American Bandstand. Dick Clark, he played the top 40, the kids, they would dance. Dick Clark hosted American Bandstand from 52 to 89, so it's quite just like 30 seconds, it's like hundreds of episodes. You can watch other kids would dance to the top 40 that Dick Clark would play. Gotta be artists, they would come on to make musical performances. Dick Clark, he'd interview people, picture the show. Watch the Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet, where Ricky Nelson got his start. All those great shows. The Honeymooners, I Love Lucy, great shows, of course. Movies, you gotta really be into your movies. So, of course, 1955, Rebel Without a Cause, starring James Dean, Natalie Wood, and Sal Mineo. And of course, your three James Dean movies, East of Eden, Rebel Without a Cause, and Giant in History movies. Of course, Marilyn Monroe movies, Audrey Hepburn movies, Marlon Brando movies, great Grace Kelly movies, Leslie Caron movies, Anna Margaret movies, Sandra Dee movies, and Coachella movies, The Beach Party, Jane Seberg movies, all of that, if you cats and kids want me to, I can make a video on, my 50s movie guide. The best movies of, the 50s, even the Elvis movies, Leslie Caron movies, the jukebox movies from the 50s, Rock Around the Clock, Don't Knock the Rock, Twist Around the Clock, Don't Knock the Twist, there's a lot, Go Johnny Go, there's a lot that I'm forgetting to mention, because if you guys want me to, I can do a video talking about, a complete guide to the 50s movies. Now that we've got, your culture, if you're a guy like me, of course, you're going to want to be into the know about the 50s chicks. Well, there's Marilyn Monroe, Bridget Bardot, Jane Mansfield, Audrey Hepburn, Sandra Dee, Grace Kelly, Annette Funicello, Leslie Caron, Gene Seberg, Jane Simmons, Gene Shrimpton. There's all the Genes back then. It's kind of crazy. Gene Tenery, Ava Gardner, like I said, Grace Kelly, Anne Margaret, all the really fine chicks in the 50s, except Nick. Yeah, it's like, I'm looking around, how did I forget? The best chick of them all, Natalie Wood. Speaking of Natalie Wood, I was talking about, on Discord, I was talking to my friend Purcells earlier, and we were talking about, the Natalie Wood bikini photos from 1969. She was like, I just want to fuck her brains out. I was like, yeah. But anyways, love root beer. That's what the soul of the cats were drinking in the 50s, and the root beer Coca-Cola. There is either root beer, which was mainly A&W, Coca-Cola, Pepsi-Cola. Some were drinking Sprite right at the end, and of course, your milkshakes. Love milkshakes. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. So, after a chick, of course, you feel a woman about your guys. Now, the attractive guys of the 50s, you know, you have Ricky Nelson, Elvis, of course, Frankie Avalon, Bobby Rydell, Fabian. Oh, yeah, how did I forget this one when I was talking about the 50s music? You're going to want to be listening to Neil Sedaka. But yeah, so I talked about, you know, your chick slash guys, you know, your movies, your TV shows, your music, your fashion. I'm trying to think, really, what left is there, really? Oh, yeah, you know, what your activities, like you do for fun, of course. Like, you listen to records slash the radio. Like, you watch your old TV shows. You might go down to the theater, you know, the drive-in, or like, just regular movie theater. If there's a drive-in in your area, that's what I recommend going to. But unfortunately, I've never had this experience because there's no retro theaters around. But if there's, like, a movie theater that shows, like, 50s movies, you know, like, what I claim to be the golden era of 46 to 56, those 20 years. If there's a movie, if there's a theater in your area that shows the vintage movies, so I can go for it. And, you know, hang out with your 50s enthusiast pals. And find a hangout spot, you know, like the local diner, if there is one, the small shop, you know, the soda shop. You know, the hangout spots in the 50s. I'm going to do a tutorial, probably soon, on how to pull 50s enthusiast chicks. Because I want one really badly. You know, like Sandra D, you know, all sweet and pure and innocent. I'm not gonna fuck your brains out. Oh, wait, what? Anyways, like I said, you listen to records, watch your TV, go to the theater, you know, you go to the hangout spot, hang out with your pals, you know. And just overall, just, you know, have some fun, you know. You know, you're not on the internet, you know, you go out fucking touch grass, or you read fucking books even. Speaking of reading books, you know, I have that book, you know, Sexiest Chicks from the 50s, and I have a magazine of some retro cars. That's another, you know, so you need to call it books and magazines of the end of the era. Speaking of cars, that's another activity. Take your pals or your chick or whatever, you even go by your fucking self and go to the fucking car show, the fucking the hot rod show. Now, I've been to quite a few car shows in my lifetime. I'm also forget about this. If you're a cat, if you're a guy, in your 50s, gonna fucking watch. But yeah, these must go with shorts and shirts. Like, I fucking have this on. But yeah, you're not playing fucking video games, you know. You're not fucking stuck inside being a fucking incel. Also, I have these. My favorite restaurant, Steak and Shake. I like their napkins. Route 66, honey. Whoa! Also, speaking of Lewin, that's another artist from the 50s that you should listen to, Jerry Lee Lewis. But, yeah. That's really all there is to say, you know, be a traditionalist, you know. If you're a cat, you know, you should go out and work once you're married. If you're a chick, you know, you're gonna stay home, take care of the home, take care of the kids, you know, you don't work. No, just have a traditional marriage, you know. If you're a 50s enthusiast, you know, you're just ought to be, you know, traditionalism. Traditionalism is always good, you know. I hate progressiveness, I hate the woke virus. Feminist virus, yuck. LGBTQ virus, yuck. You know, it's all fucking standards, you know. But yeah, like I said, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, goddamn. Like I said, you know, just be traditional, conservative, don't be woke, you know, don't be feminist, don't be LGBTQ. That's really all there is to say. This was supposed to be a better video than what it is, you know, really, but there's not really much to say. And the fourth inconvenient, I tackle everything. I said, you know, your ideology, you know, you vote Republican. I'm not talking about your chicks, your guys, your fashion, your music, your TV shows, your music, your, you know, what you do for fun. And there's really not much to do. And so, I hate to end it early. You know, we're at 24 minutes, but there's not really much to talk about. And so, goddamn. I gotta get back in the habit of making these videos again. So, stay cool, don't be a fool. I wanna be Mario Miguel.